shot with the air. I will expire soon.
Looks like more of the legionnaires sent to investigate the lighthouse.
I needed that.
Thank you. rocket banner already.
Pushing, pulling, lifting, look at him muscles, huh? Just like my days at the fair. I used to sail the seven seas with the best of them. Better than the best of them. But found my true calling at the county fair. The strongest man in Scythiel I was. And they built me as such. Now those were swell times. How people marveled at my feats of strength. Boy, was I the cat pajamas back then. Anyone could go up against me in a grand old bare-knuckle jamboree, but did they ever best me? Baloney. Now, I'm not a violent guy. Don't get me wrong. Make no mistake. But you know there's no harm in a little roughhousing now and again. Putting on a show for the roaring crowd. Plenty challenged me in those days, but none managed to best Snorri. No, sir. Scrawny against Brawny. Could have been a knight title fight at the fair. Here are the rules, hotcha. I'm gonna summon an item. Something only Snorri himself could smash. And if you can manage to break it in 35 seconds, you'll have won the challenge. Go get noodle arms. So, what are you made of?
Thank you.
prepared to face the strongest ghost alive. Well...
It's the Source Hunter. We're not going to die on this haunted cliff after all.
Who's dying? We're just resting up. The calm before the storm. Those ghosties at the lighthouse won't know what hit them. There's certainly something fishy happening. The light shines sure as the tides. Though there's not been an attendant there for nearly two decades. Our platoon made a pact with Selenia. We'd check out the lighthouse, and if we made it back, we'd get a ticket home.
What Selenia failed to mention was that it wasn't just the ghosts at the lighthouse we had to worry about, it was every savage skeleton on the way there and back too. When we started, we were seven. Now, Lucia and I are the last alive.
Survival of the fittest, I say. We're just here marshalling our strength before hauling into that lighthouse with our swords blazing.
Ha! Marshalling our strength indeed. To be honest, we've been shaking like chihuahuas, praying for a way out of this mess. And it seems the Seven have sent you.
Ha! Malleus, your dignity's in a puddle at your feet. As for me, an honourable soldier and servant to Rivelon, I'm not afraid to ask. So... what do you say, Source Hunter? Will you check out the lighthouse in the name of your comrades in arms? If Selenia sees the place cleared, we'll be on the next ship out to Sicile and back to our families.
You'll go to the lighthouse and straighten matters out, yes? Well, let us know what you find.
like I've been set in stone. The wildlife.
The further we go, the more bodies we find heaped around.
We must be closing in on where they were headed.
Chance within me. The mend. Thank you. feet again.
To welcome you.
coil. The seven call me home.
Failing. Fast. into the fray once more.
Assume you address me, and so let the hunt con.
I see your eyes before me still. Were that I could drown in their endless azure and end this torment.
A stitch in time, eh, my friend?
I see your eyes before me still. Were that I could the ship up the way.
I've heard powerful undead like the lighthouse ghoul never truly die, but lie in wait to be resurrected again.
Folly. Oh, grievous sin. What's this? Living eyes that can see the shape of death? Avert your gaze, wanderer. For you are looking upon the phantom of a murderer. Samson was my name, a long time ago. I know not why, upon my death, I became a ghost, doomed to haunt this tower. Perhaps the gods heard of my crime, and stripped me of my rightful place in their eternal realm. If so, their punishment was just. Each night, I wake the flame in the lighthouse to repent for my wretched sin. That indeed is the tainted title I must bear, and deservedly so. For 15 years ago to the day, it was that I sat atop my lighthouse, the flame unlit, and watched on as a pitiable ship crashed upon the cliff and got devoured by greedy whales. Deliberately had I foregone to do my duty. Willfully did I condemn every soul aboard to a salty sleep on the bed of an indifferent sea. Why did I commit this act of blackest horror? Jealousy, anger, the bitter anguish of a broken heart. Those are the ancient ills that drove me to madness. Desdemona was on board, as I knew she would be. My wife, the delicate beauty of whom I was sure, was betraying me with her friend, the dashing Falada. Possessed as I was by the demons of envy, ire, and torment, I decided that if I had her love no longer, only death could take her for his mistress. And so I sat here, coldly and calmly, as I delivered them both unto the deep. Yet no sooner had the water closed its spuming jaws around the perishing vessel below, than the extent of my offense dawned on my beleaguered mind.
Overcome with guilt, I sought escape through the hangman's noose. But rest was not to come. Skeletons roam the lands, restless as my troubled soul. But shall not find their lair here. Some scuttle by now and again. But most of the time, I reside here in solitude. Solitude and silence.
Another betrayed soul. It is weakness that he weeps for her. Her death was deserved.
Speaking of deserved deaths, will you can it, or do I need to can you?
Quite a story that ghost had to tell. Not every day one hears about a lighthouse keeper sinking ships just because his wife proved to be unfaithful.
But my guilt lives
a contemptible on. Man, if ever I met one. May hell be his eventual fate.
He did commit murder with malice